Or was that a headlock suplex? I don't know. Anyway, Logan tells on Kazarian, kick to the gut. Nice little series of hits. But Austin has none of that as he gets in the spark to boot for his trouble. Late game flag up. Come back tonight. Shoulder tackle. Counter. Throw to the corner. Fully making his way there. And a nice little series of comeback moves. Running elbow right there. Even a 7-foot guy who used to be an ex-truck driver can do a Russian leg sweep. Or anyone can do a jackknife powerbomb. And I think Kazarian just got knocked the fuck out. Time of the match, 14 minutes, 22 seconds. And it seems like if this was supposed to have been Mark Austin's initiation match into McMillan Enterprises, he done a hell of a good job. As we see highlights from this match, devastating knee backbreaker by Gonzalez. Come to think of it, I think the only reason why these two, Austin and Gonzalez, won this match fair out was because of the power game. As we see another look at that devastating glory bomb by Gonzalez. Boot to the jaw right there, I didn't quite catch that. Wow. Still, if this was Mark Austin's initiation match into McMillan Enterprises, he done a great job. Well, folks, that's it for me. I just supposed to be right back, but I'll see you all at Supernova. Enjoy the rest of the show, y'all. Peace.
Can't stand the weight? Conflicted over characters? Like it? Hate it? DVR it. With direct viewer response on the URWL rant board. Simply register for the rant board at urwlrantboard.proboards.com and click on feedback forum / direct viewer response. The direct viewer response subforum is a series of polls that lets you vote, comment, and make your mark on the URWL. Be as friendly, as harsh, or as critical as you want. We need your advice. So do it. DVR it. Direct viewer response from the URWL.
Thank you.
We have a chance with the CCL Pulse, and I'm joined by my co-commentator for the CCL Grammy, DP People Champ.
What's going on, everybody? I'm sitting backstage hanging out with everybody, getting ready to flip them over. The boss asked me to come on out here and finish all the show, so here I am.
We haven't done both of them in a while, have we?
No. Nope. Episode 102, one of those two.
Yeah. As we see, the team of Bowen Thunder, Bowen Constrictor, that tournament is full of black entertainment from Boston, Maryland.
It's like a
they may be ready to buzz call that.
Yeah, no. Yeah.
Get back shot burada diktafon atak kağıt kalem bir de ilham alınacak tam gaz çapası havada düşmana buna çıkalım bakalım hadi bu medoda kazanalım. They can never manage, we do damage with no apology. Pick him off the panic, a little manic, cause I gotta be frantic. I'm a gemic, cause I'm an oddity. Gobble the track up like I'm grabbing the mama knock, cause I can pop a true proper, cause I'm partners, I'm rockin' flocker. Give me the top, I hip hop and watch him make him rock with a showstopper. Chakras popping off the
worldwide choppers.
If you anybody, you notice it. Tech is the pinnacle, not an identical soul is it. Little code is the polar, get rolled quick and they quoted it. Yo,
Chip.
Yes, sir.
This is Black Anaconda's CCL debut. I kind of feel sorry for him because he's doing it up against two very football individuals.
Oh yeah, I was going to say that Anaconda looks like a formal tag team, but he's going up against this guy, Smokey, who could be one of three men, or he could easily be a part of that gauntlet match coming up at Supernova in a couple of weeks. And he's definitely one of the pissed off guys.
He can be very busy at Supernova. He's got 38 teams in the running for a job at tag team title. So here comes Smokey Pulse.
Smokey and Sherman came out to make the save, which set up the matchup at Supernova where Suspect, Smokey, and Sherman Samson could be getting a one-on-one opportunity against Black in the cage, or all three of them could get a shot at him in a gauntlet match inside of Steel Cage.
It could be. Oh! It could be a very long match for the Nationals.
And it's going to be a busy night for Suspect. Him and Smokey are teaming together. They're one of a couple teams vying for a side to side title.
And here we go. It'll be Bowen the Constrictor and Smokey starting off here. Oh, wait, that was him by Bowen.
Oh, I remember watching him during his days of Revolution Season 1. He is a tough SOB. Tough.
I'm a...
Okay.
Look at him, 1 year ago this weekend on last year's Supernova, and both the Slipper took the now World Heavyweight Champion, Aaron Alexander, to the limit.
Yes, he did. That's what I said. Bo is a tough individual. I'm interested to see what his brother, Black Anaconda, can do.
Now it's hit the verse by Smokey, the drop kick in the throat.
Beautiful drop kick by the man from Georgiana, Alabama.
Speaking of Alabama, they had a pretty good weekend.
Yeah, they really did. You know, college football's back. I know a lot of people are excited. I'm hoping that the Maryland Terps don't, you know, lay a shit of brick this year. It's possible, though.
I would say it's almost a death hit.
Yeah.
That's just as Black Anaconda is in. Looks like Black Anaconda from where it's set. Oh, what a surprise!
Wow! What strength. Smokey's not coming there.
Yeah, kind of looks like about 6'3", 240, 245, I would think.
Yeah, looks about just about that. He does look smaller than his brother.
Smokey with an Irish whip and oh, and kind of
bumping!
Smokey went high, and kind of stuck under.
Yep. Well, it still is, but Smokey might want to get a tag here and get suspect in
it. Okay, so. Following this match, we'll have highlights of the hardcore title match between Brent Harvinator and Aaron Alexander. If you haven't heard by now, the hardcore title is not
based. Yeah.
All that we explain in the highlight then. By the way, you can vote on who will compete for the hardcore title. Not only who will compete for it, but under what stipulation is that?
Rocket launcher.
Rocket launcher then. And a protobomb and then just the one as Anaconda kicks out.
Yeah, that's right. You can vote on who's going to be involved in the hardcore title match and what stipulation that it will be contested under. Remember, you got until midnight Labor Day to do it.
Midnight tomorrow. German suplex. Off the German suplex, only a one.
Man, but I did check out most of the show before I came out here. And what a surprise. That tough-ass son of a bitch, the real Gregory Black, yet again.
Oh,
like I said, when it comes to Supernova, you'll have nowhere to run and nowhere to hide.
Goes on by Anaconda. Has a leg cut. Almost had a mighty middle upset there.
Right. I'm a little upset that I wasn't out here when Demon Eek was out here, but I feel later on though. Look out.
All right, that's right. Yeah, I believe Bo might have distracted the referee there.
I believe he did. That was a good veteran move by Bo, even though he's only been around for a little over a year. At least here.
Oh, before this, he was a body. He was a bodyguard in the. He was a bouncer in at a club in Boston. So yeah, that veteran move for a guy who's not been around a long time.
Nice combination, backbreaker rushing last week by Black Anaconda.
Anaconda's looking impressive here in this first round. And another spine buster.
He's doing those spine busters like Arn Anderson, or if you remember back in TNA 2002-2003, David Young.
I know this will come off weird, but I didn't watch TNA in the other day.
I only started watching it because I've been on the internet recently and I just started looking at it and I just realized that some of their storylines were kind of crazy, but that's just me. They sure did advertise and condone domestic violence though. I'm not even going to lie.
Oh, look at this, eh? Oh, no!